to do. Oh. your volcano ought to explode. You be so full of all the things that all God is doing for you. How can you sit there and don't do anything? You ought to come in sometime and set the whole church on fire. No explosion.
Yes.
Can I get a witness in here? Number seven. Sincere questioning as you learn about the others.
Yes.
And we watched our leaders. Can I get a witness in here?
Watch.
Your leader living right. Praise God. You ought to consider it. You watch that. That's but a lot of people, they're not sincere. They want to question everything. But not in sincerity.
Come on,
they question for debate.
Well,
they question for argument.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Learn about the others. Praise God. I watch my leaders. I watch the saints. Y'all, they saying that how they got around the altar and prayed, and that taught me.
Yes.
I watch my bishop on Friday night. We had shut in. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Shut me in with God. I watched him, and from that day that I learned, I took it upon myself.
All right now. Come on.
And I've been doing it ever since.
All right now. Yes.
I don't wait till I get to the church. I lay out at night on the side of my bed.
Come on now.
Can I get a window?
Yeah.
When I see the devil move, I'm going to lay out some more.
Amen.
Hello?
Come on
now. I learned that from my leaders.
That's right.
And guess what? It works.
Yes. Hallelujah.
It don't work for some people because they haven't learned anything. Number eight, studying the other's person.
That's right.
Memorizing each line of the faith as an example. Can I get a witness in here? My leaders was examples. And I memorized the thing that my bishop told me. I memorized the bishop that the thing that Bishop Campbell told me and instilled within me. I don't sit there and debate, argue back and forth with the leaders.
Come on, man.
Disrespect the leaders. Somebody said God can shut them up, they won't tell you nothing.
That's right.
I memorized those things. Even my wife sometimes say, oh my God, I miss Bishop Campbell. I miss my leader. Because the way some of these people, they talk backwards.
Yes, they do.
Come on, somebody.
Right.
We wonder where they come from. What side of the track they was on.
Amen.
But act like they don't know nothing half of the time. If you have a relationship with God, the Holy Ghost will lead and guide you into all truth and all righteousness, even though you don't fully understand. And I can't even begin to tell you the nights I spent on my knees, crawling in the bed 4 days the next morning before the break of day. But it brought me to where I am today. If our love for Christ is cold, say cold. It doesn't matter how faithfully we serve him or how rightly we believe or how strongly we stand. If you miss the first base, it doesn't matter how far you hit the ball or how many bases you touch. If you miss the first base, you out. You out. Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You out.
You out.
If you leave your first love, you are out of his favor. Good God.
Out.
Are y'all listening to me?
Out. Yes, sir.
You lose the first love, you're going to wind up in a mess. Hello?
Amen.
Y'all still in here?
Yes.
God said, and I'm including me. Amen. Come back.
First love.
Amen.
Can I get a witness in here?
Amen.
Come back. Somebody need to make a comeback.
Come back.
I know something left out of here, but praise God, that's all right.
Amen. Come back.
Revelation itself is a book, a book revealing Jesus.
That's right. Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
Unto John, talk about John the Baptist.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, they crucified me. I know what they're gonna. You know, before I finished preaching, I knew I was gonna be in trouble with some folks,
amen.
But I didn't care.
Amen.
Cause God called me to preach, not man.
Amen.
Amen.
Man,
when
it shuts up, you don't want you to preach.
And see, in these day and time, it's not church as usual.
No,
but when God called me to pastor and preach, it wasn't church as usual there. Cause whatever the Lord led me to do, it didn't care nothing about how they. You know what I mean? Tradition. I didn't move by that.
That's right.
Amen. I moved by how the Lord, you know, the same old format, come to church. On Sunday morning, when all the mixed up spirits come in there, I said, I ain't preaching over this mess. Come on, somebody, come on down here. Come on, y'all need to get the spirits right. A lot of people preach over mess and junk. Come on, somebody.
Amen to that.
Just to keep a member. Or somebody praying their tithe. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
God didn't call me to tell his people a bunch of lies.
That's right.
Can I get a witness in here? He called me, and when I first got said, Lord, one thing I'm going to do, I'm going to tell your people the truth.
Yes, Lord.
It could have killed me, but it was all right. Couldn't kill the spirit, the soul, kill the flesh. But I learned that over the down through the years, when truth come along and they don't want to hear, they will crucify you.
My Lord.
They will. Yes, they will.
Praise the Lord.
My.
It was a revelation to Jesus. It's whom John is seeing. And we all ought to be seeing Jesus. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And it is Jesus that is speaking to him.
All right, yeah.
Yes.
And speaking about.
Yeah.
What was.
What is.
What is. And what is to come.
Yeah.
Are y'all listening to me?
Yes.
Yes. Therefore, God is speaking to these churches. God is speaking, and he's still speaking to churches today.
Yes.
A lot of them don't want to hear him, but that's all right. That day gonna surely come.
Well.
It is a message that is specific.
Yes.
For as we can see from the background, already stated that Ephesians effectively disappeared off the map. Some people start out, we see them disappear off the map. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
An ancient city in West Asia Minor, famous temple, Artemis, Ephesians of Diana. It was an early Christian community.
Okay.
It was famous for the temple of Diana.
Yes. But
more so for having this part I like. A church of Christ in it. What good is, you know, a church and God ain't in it? Huh? Now we know a building is a building where we go to worship, but we, you know what I mean, we're the church. So if you're the church, what good is your church and God ain't in it?
Ain't no good.
Gotta think about it. Saved, supposed to be sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, ongoing Christian, pay your tithes, and give your offering, and God ain't even in your church.
My Lord.
That make any sense? That's a question.
No, that don't make no sense.
I want to waste all these years and all my time and get old and know one day I got to leave here and don't have Christ, keep Christ in this church. The Apostle Paul came and he preached and continued for the space of 2 years. Where a very famous church was planted by him and proper officers appointed, to whom he wrote a very excellent epistle.
Yeah.
But look at it now. Now, this is now a miserable, desolate place not a city no more, but it's a village. Are y'all listening to me? Hallelujah. Miserable?
Well,
mean manifesting misery. When God ain't in your church, let me tell you, you're going to be a miserable person after a while. Can I get a witness in here?
Amen, amen, amen.
You will become a wretched undone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, people, y'all have a habit, and then you look around, y'all sad, sad.
Yeah.
Miserable. Because it don't last long. Somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
Just let the money run out. You're going to see a miserable person. Wretched, unhappy.
Because
see, the money will make them happy.
Yes.
Things make them happy.
Yes.
But I remember the time you didn't know whether I had money or not. But I was still happy in the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. Money didn't make me happy. Because if I didn't have it, I'm going to still be happy in Jesus.
Yes. Yes.
But some people, how you doing? Oh, here it goes. Here it comes. They're going to tell you everything about Jesus.
Amen.
Come on, y'all.
Amen.
You don't even want to ask them how they're doing. Matter of fact, you don't have, all you have to do is look at them and you will know. They're miserable. Because if you got Jesus going on, you got to know that the house belongs to God, the cattle on a thousand hill belongs to God, the gold and the money belongs to the Lord.
Amen.
So if you got Jesus going on in you, he's going to make a way out of no way.
Yes, he will.
Hallelujah.
He sure will.
Miserable. Mean unease. That's a person that's going to be unease.
Yeah.
They're uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And then they don't want to be around the saints anyway. Somebody say amen. This is not a miserable and a dissonant place. A place that was famous. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Was a city but became a village.
Yeah.
Dissonant means barren or laid that way.
Wow.
You see some people, amen, they're barren, don't have no joy, no love, and they're just wasting time.
Yeah.
Yeah, wasting a whole lot of time doing nothing. Ain't going nowhere. No joy, no happiness, no peace. Come on, y'all. No love. They're dissonant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank
you, Lord. Yes, 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 yes.
Devastated.
Yeah.
Thank you, my Lord.
Solitary. They're lonely.
Yes, yes, yes,
yes. Y'all, one thing about I found about the Lord, you can have an empty space and the Holy Ghost will fill it up. You don't have to be right here lonely. Can I get away? You can be in the midst of 100 people and still feel like there's nobody to know. The loneliness is you got to learn how to ask God to fill up the void. Can I get away? You want to be loved, but Jesus said he loves you. But you got to come to him. Can I get away? It's a dissonant place. Having the feeling of being abandoned. They get to the place of being abandoned. They think, don't nobody love them. Somebody say, the devil start telling them a lot of lies. First of all, if don't nobody love them, Jesus loved you because he died for us all.
Yeah.
Yeah. Having the feeling of being abandoned by friends or by hope. Then we, no hope. The devil tell you you ain't got nothing, you ain't getting, you ain't going nowhere. Nobody gonna do nothing for you. He be talking to you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Mm-mm.
That's a dissonant place. And I refuse to be there.
Well,
do I have any witnesses here tonight?
Amen.
I refuse to be in a dissonant place. Devil stayed in a solitary place. I'm not alone. Matter of fact, he said he'll be with you even to the end of this world. 2nd chapter of Revelation, unto the angels of the church.
I feel seasons everywhere, and I feel blessed. seeds in me, those seeds that you sow. You're gonna come into your own seeds, walk into your seeds. It's time to come into your own seeds. Walk into your seeds. I believe we're in a time when God's gonna bless the saints. Those who have stayed, those who have prayed, He's gonna fulfill the promise He made. For I heard the Spirit say, it's your time, the way is over. Walk into your seat.